Thank you. In this time, I will give talks about REST versus GraphQL. At first, let me introduce myself. My name is Yuri Pratama. I start as PHP developer at early days at 2010, and now I just falling in love with front end stuff. Now I work for my startup Tabook, and I also organize committee in UX community. Okay. Okay. Why I want to give talks about REST and GraphQL, because for a few years ago, GraphQL is more popular over REST, and I want to know who have never using REST? Who has never using REST? Yeah. I think every developers in already know REST, and who have ever tried GraphQL? Anyone? Yes. I think GraphQL is popular for a few years. Basically, REST and GraphQL is same. There are ways to send the data over HTTP. So maybe it's no difference. And they also offers API design architecture to build web services. So basically they are same. So what is the difference between REST and GraphQL? Because we know when we using REST and when we using GraphQL, we notice the difference between them. Every developers know what REST is, and it's common use by developers. And I think I will not explain what is REST. I will explain what is pros about REST. At first, REST is very popular, and I think every developer will know what is REST. REST have consistent endpoint name, and it's a clear and obvious name, such as if we have endpoint name users and name to-dos. Yeah, if we want to get the users data, we should call the endpoint name users, and if we want to call the endpoint to-dos, so we just call it to-dos. Because it used long time ago, so REST API have maturity and also stable. We not talk about it. And then because REST is sent over HTTP, so request using REST is cacheable, so the data will be cached on the client. And REST have it based on error handling. I mean, if we successfully request the data, it will return us some like 200 okay, and if it error, we will receive something like maybe 500 internal server error or something like that. But REST not only have pros, but REST have some cons. The most issue about REST is it have multiple round trips. For example, if we want to request the user's data and we want to request the maybe courses data, we need to send requests to multiple endpoint. So the performance is bad, and we need to specify it individual endpoints. And then REST, we can custom the response from REST because the data is we receive bunch of many data, we can custom it. So if we want to just fetch it name or it some fields, is impossible. So overfetching and underfetching data in REST is most issue. Because of that, I will try to comparing how can GraphQL solve the problem of REST. So what is GraphQL? GraphQL is same with REST, but different methods. GraphQL is declarative data fetching fetching specification and query language for APIs. It created by Facebook in 2012 and open source in 2015. So GraphQL is used in Facebook. If I'm not wrong, GitHub API also use GraphQL. Some people call it REST 2.0 because it have improvement from the original REST. GraphQL offer have only single endpoint, not like REST, because GraphQL have just single endpoint. Because of that, GraphQL offers flexibility and performance. They are have better performance. Okay, let's see REST and GraphQL in action. I will try to give you an example how can REST and GraphQL have difference when we try to request the data. Okay. For example, I take some of example from the PHP conference website. When we need to fetching the speakers list data, actually each of speakers data have many of fields. They are not only have name or bio data, but it also have the another data that we are not needed. Because for example, if we want to display something like that, we only have we only need name, maybe description, bio data, or Twitter handle. Yeah, this is example URL maybe. If in REST, we try to call something like get https maybe api.phpconf.asia/speakers, so it will return the data maybe something like that. The data is very, there's many of data, and we just need it all to display the list of speakers. This is array of objects. So if in GraphQL, we just request POST to maybe https phpconf.asia/GraphQL, just single endpoint, something like that, we can custom the parameters, the field we need, because to display like this, we only need title, name, description, biodata, and maybe Twitter. And then we receive the response like this. Okay. It's same if we fetching some data like this, it's more simple, not like this. Maybe it complex, but it more simple, and we have many fields data in our database, and we can only call the data that we need, like name, avatar, maybe company, and Twitter handle, but, or Twitter username. And GraphQL send response like this, only the data we need return to as response. And you can notice that the endpoint still same, the method also still same, but we have different queries. So we have pros of GraphQL. GraphQL have single round trip because we only have single endpoint. We only execute single endpoint, so it not request too many endpoint and affect the performance. And also because we can custom the response data, it offers flexibility. We can custom what the data will be display, and it will be loved by front-end developers, because front-end developer maybe sometimes will be pain if receive many of data or fields. But GraphQL have cons. Not like REST, GraphQL have bad on error handling, because if we try to execute GraphQL, it always have 200 OK, even it error. So we don't know about the error, because it also always give 200 OK. And then GraphQL cannot be caged and need some libraries and frameworks to enable the cage in client. So when we should use REST, or when we should use GraphQL, it depends on our needs. If we have only few entities, few data, or few relationship, it should be fit if we use REST because it's simple. And if we have more complex entities and relationship, we should use GraphQL because GraphQL offers many of benefit. So the conclusion is we should use right tools for the right job. If we try to use REST, we can optimize the REST and it will boost the performance. Okay. Okay, thank you.